It's a nearly 13-year case full of twists and turns, and day one of David Camm's third murder trial proves no different with a request for a mistrial.
Camm's charged with killing his wife and children in their Georgetown home, but he's being tried in Lebanon, Indiana, to ensure an unbiased jury. WLKY's Lexi Sheen is live from Floyd County, where the case began. She has the latest developments. Lexi?
Well, Monica, probably the biggest development from yesterday, from day one, was the prosecution's motion for a mistrial. That was after the defense mentioned Charles Bonet's foot fetish during opening statements. Now, that detail was previously ruled inadmissible by the judge, who considered the motion and then ultimately denied it, making way for witness testimony.
It's hard to sit there and see. You know, I try not to look at the pictures, but just get up here and just hear that over again. It's like bringing back memories.
All three victims died from a single gunshot wound 13 years ago. Special Prosecutor Stan Lefko told the court Camm's motive was insurance money, adding it's tiny drops of Jill's blood found on Camm's shirt that convict him. The state says that's high velocity impact spatter from a gunshot, but the defense argues it's transfer from when Camm leaned over Jill to reach for Brad to do CPR. This time around, for the first time, the jury will hear more about Bonet. He's the man previously convicted in the Camm murders. His DNA, palm print, and clothing were all found at the scene.
Maybe gets more difficult every time because of what we know can happen, and we know that juries can come back with unjust verdicts.
Now, also during opening statements, the defense told the jury that 11 witnesses placed Camm on a basketball court as those murders happened. The jury also got to hear the call that Camm made to Indiana State Police, to his old post, in fact, rather than 911, when he came home to find his family dead. Reporting live, I'm Lexi Sheen, WLKY News.